Good evening, folks. We're going to start tonight with the toll the pandemic has taken on our hospital systems and the people who work there. Waves of COVID cases followed by an influx of people who delayed care for serious conditions strained our hospitals in a lot of ways. But a new report released today is showing us how it impacted the care, specifically in 2021. The report is called the Adverse Health Events Report. Kent's here to break down what that means, but let's start with what's the definition of that.
Well, Jenna, it's a report that breaks down medical mistakes and other serious injuries that happen to patients while they're being cared for in a hospital or a surgical center. Minnesota was the first state in the country to start making these reports publicly available back 17 years ago, and it has generally helped lead to fewer mistakes. But last year, it reversed course, jumping by 33%.
These are events that usually result in harm and are usually preventable.
Not only did the total number of adverse health events in Minnesota jump from 382 in 2020 to 508 in 2021, but the most harmful events jumped at a larger rate, with 207 resulting in serious injury and 14 ending in death. On the surface, the reason why is simple.
We do know that during the pandemic, hospitals were taking care of more patients, sicker patients, and they were taking care of patients for longer periods of time.
According to the report, the average length of ICU stay more than doubled from 2.3 days in 2017 to nearly 5.5 days in 2021. And those longer stays led to sizable increases in the two most common adverse events, pressure ulcers or severe bed sores and serious falls.
How much do you think staffing and staffing shortages played into this?
I think it did play a part.
Kanan Ramar, Mayo Clinic's chief patient safety officer, says staff burnout and even the length of time it took to don and doff PPE also contributed. Yet he says when you consider the influx of patients and longer stays last year, the actual rate of adverse events remained level. He says that's a credit to staff and why they are working now to better support them.
And that includes addressing issues related to workforce shortage, having strategies in place for burnout, fatigue among our staff have all been instituted.
But with no end in sight for the staffing crunch, he says Mayo Clinic is also looking to artificial intelligence to make their jobs easier.
So we've developed predictive models for pressure injuries. We are in the process of developing a predictive model for falls to help us mitigate these. Is hugely important.
MDH says that's the point of the reporting system, to see shortfalls in real time and share best practices.
Adverse health events are extremely rare. We had 508 events out of almost 5 million adjusted patient days served in 2020, but we do know that we need to redouble our efforts to keeping patients safe, and we will be working with our partners over the next several months to do that.
Now, the Minnesota Nurses Association has been highlighting these types of issues surrounding staffing and staff burnout specifically for months now. Back in May, they pointed to a 300% increase in concern for safe staffing forms filed by nurses since 2014. And these issues are central right now to contract negotiations that we've talked about here that have stalled with several Twin Cities hospitals. Today, Union President Mary Turner wrote in a statement, "We urge hospital executives to listen to nurses and to work with us to keep nurses at the bedside with a seat at the table to address staffing, retention, and patient needs for the future." So, Jana, this is something that certainly we'll be hearing a lot more about as some of these issues boil over.
Right. That report comes out at a pretty timely space for the nurses who are looking for that new contract. You're absolutely right.
Yeah.
Thanks, Kent.